another fun and exciting Sunday school lesson here at Father's Heart Kidz. I can't wait now to get started. So let's quickly close our eyes and open today's lesson with prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to worship and glorify you in this day. We're just so grateful to be here and that we get the opportunity to learn more about you and your word. Thank you, Lord, for being with us during our lesson. Please help us to concentrate and learn all there is to know about your word and how you want us to live. And Lord, please help us to completely give over to you while we just praise and worship you today. In Jesus' name we pray this, and we all say, Amen. So guys, who's now ready to praise and worship God? I know I am. So guys, I really want to encourage you guys now to just let go and enjoy this time with us. Now, as you guys know, there will be words and motions on the screen so you guys can follow along and praise God with all that you've got. So let's not wait any further and let's praise and worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus.
Let's take it up one more time. Every praise. together pray to you. My little feet together follow you. I lift my eyes and look to you, and my heart will love you. God, you are my Father, Jesus Christ, my friend. Holy Spirit, you help me on my way.
Guys, that was just so much fun. I just love singing and dancing with you guys for God. But anyways, let's now get to our Bible story of today. Today's story is called A Captain's Faith. Now, to give you guys some background to our story so you can understand it a bit better, in the time of Jesus, Rome ruled over Israel and also many other places. Now, it's important to know that the Romans were really cruel and harsh leaders. They treated the Israelites and everyone under them really badly. They were like the type of people who killed and then asked questions later. Yep, they were really that horrible, guys. Now, to make sure everyone listened to them, they had a really strong army that roamed the streets to make sure everyone followed their rules. Now guys, a captain was in charge of about 80 to 100 of these soldiers, and he made sure they did their job. And guys, to make matters not even worse, the Romans didn't believe in God like the Jews. They only followed Caesar. Now, back to today's story. After Jesus taught the people on the mountain, he came down to a nearby city. Now, obviously, the word had spread about Jesus and who he is and that he is now there. And this is when a captain came to Jesus and asked him something. Now, guys, this in itself is very strange. But don't worry, it didn't end badly. this captain wasn't like the other Romans. He was different. Now, before I give way too much away of a story, let's watch it together. A captain's faith. Matthew 8, verse 5 to 13. Jesus came down the mountain to a nearby city. Crowds of people gathered to see him. An army captain said, "Lord Jesus, my servant is very sick. Please, will you help him?" Jesus said, "I will go to your house and heal him." The captain replied, "You do not need to go to my house. Just say the word and my servant will be healed." Jesus was amazed. "I have not found anyone whose faith is so strong." Then Jesus said to the captain, "Go, your servant is healed." The captain ran home. He was happy to see his servant well again. See, I told you guys that it wasn't going to end badly. Now, after seeing today's story, you guys probably don't believe what I told you earlier about the Romans. But it's true, guys. The Romans were really bad. Well, except for this captain. He was different from all the other Romans. Now, what made him so different was his faith. So much so that Jesus was even amazed at his faith. Now, guys, when looking at today's story, there are actually three things that we can learn from it. Number one is love your enemies. You see, guys, back in the day, the Jews and the Romans didn't really sit at the same table. They didn't like each other at all. Now, the Jews especially didn't like the Romans because they were being oppressed by them. And to top it off, they didn't believe in God. Now, Jesus could have easily said he's not going to help this captain because their people have caused so much pain and hurt to his people. But guys, Jesus did the opposite. He showed love and compassion. Now, guys, this is so significant. Because remember, just before this incident, Jesus was teaching on the mountain. And in his teaching, he told the people to love their enemies. And we can actually find it in Matthew 5, verse 44. And it says, "But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you." Now, guys, the reason why this is so significant is because right after Jesus taught this, he led by example. You see, Jesus never tells us to do something that he wouldn't do himself. Jesus always sets the example for us on how to live. So guys, let's follow in Jesus' footsteps. Let's love our enemies and let's pray for those who wrong us. Now, you might be thinking that's easier said than done. Jesus could easily do that as he is the Son of God. Now, that is true. He is the Son of God. But while Jesus was here on earth, Jesus was fully human. He had the same emotions you and I have, meaning he also experienced pain and hurt. But it's what he chose now to do with his emotions that made the difference. You see, Jesus always obeyed the Father and did the right thing no matter what. Now, guys, the amazing thing is we can do the same with the help of the Holy Spirit. You see, loving your enemies might be hard, but that's why we have the Holy Spirit to help us, because with his help, nothing is impossible, even something as difficult as loving and praying for those who wronged you. Now, the second thing that we can learn from today's story is to have faith. You see, Jesus wasn't amazed because a Roman came to him and asked him for his help. Jesus was amazed at the captain's faith. Now, guys, the reason why Jesus was so amazed was because not even his own disciples had faith like this captain had. Jesus' disciples doubted him many times. But here comes someone who has never even seen Jesus before. He has only heard of Jesus, and then he puts his faith in him. This actually now reminds me of our scripture we learned just a few weeks ago in John 20 verse 29, where Jesus told his disciple Thomas, "You believe because you have seen me, but blessed are those who believe without seeing me." You see, this is actually the type of faith Jesus wants us to have. We must never have the attitude of, "When I see it, I will believe it." We must be like this captain, guys, who believes even if he hasn't seen Jesus perform a miracle before. And that's exactly what faith is, guys. Faith is trusting God and believing in him no matter what. Faith is knowing that God can do the impossible even if our human minds can't understand it. So guys, let's be like this captain and have more faith in God. Trust in him no matter what. Now, that brings me to the third and the last thing that we can learn from our story, and that is to ask for help using wisdom. Now, I know this might sound like a weird thing that we can learn, but let me explain. We all have faced difficult situations, right? But so many times when we face these difficult situations, we just keep quiet and try and figure it out on our own, right? Now, in the end, we're just doing harm to ourselves. Because you see, if this captain didn't go and ask for help from Jesus, his servant most probably would have died because his servant was really sick. So in other words, sometimes we suffer because we don't ask for help. Now, the reason why I added using wisdom is because sometimes we do go and ask for help, but we ask all the wrong people. You see, this captain didn't go to a doctor or to Caesar for help, because that wasn't going to help. He went to Jesus. So, in other words, guys, we need to ask for help. God never made us to face our problems alone. But when we do ask for help, make sure to do it using wisdom. Now, to get wisdom and to know who to ask for help is to pray and ask God. He will lead you now to the right people that can help you. But that actually brings me to the next point. Jesus is like the best person to ask for help. He can literally help you with anything. You just need to open up and ask for help, just like this captain did. So, to sum up our 3 points that we just learned from our story, we need to, number one, love our enemies. Number two, have faith. Number three, ask for help using wisdom. So, with all of that said, guys, let's look at what craft we will be making to remember all of this. guys, what a cute craft. This will definitely now help us to remember our story of a captain's fate. And I can't wait now to see how yours turned out. So if you want to make your very own Roman captain craft, all you have to do is look for a blue link in the description of today's video and then download your very own copy. Now, with all of that said, let's look at how all your crafts turned out of last week's lesson, the Lord's Prayer. Crafts and how creative and unique you guys are. Thank you all so much for taking the time to make your crafts and for sending them in to me. You guys really are the joy of Father's Heart Kidz, and I'm just so happy to have you guys part of Father's Heart Kidz. Well, speaking of which, we actually had a birthday of one of our kids who is part of Father's Heart Kidz. Guys, it was Kimberly's birthday this week. So from all of us, Kimberly, happy birthday. We're just so glad to have you part of Father's Heart Kidz. May God just bless you in this year to come, and we hope you had a fantastic day. Now guys, before we go, let's quickly sing one more song together for Jesus.
Trust in the Lord with your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do. He will show you which path to take. Whoa. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Do not depend on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do. He will show you which path to take. Whoa. Oh,
Proverbs 3, 5, and 6.
Wow, guys, what a fun lesson we just had. I really had a blast with you guys today. Now, before we go, I have a big announcement to share with you guys. Now, since we are an online Sunday school, it's a bit difficult to get to know each other, right? Now, yes, I have gotten to know some of you because you send in your crafts, but there isn't really a place where you guys can meet each other. So, some of you gave me the suggestion now to get Discord for Father's Heart Kidz. Now, if you have no idea what that is, don't worry. Just a few weeks ago, I had no idea what that was myself and how it works. Now, Discord is just basically an app that you can download on your phone or on your computer. And then you can join the Father's Heart Kidz server with a link. Now, in the server, there are different channels that we can chat on, like our chat group, or our prayer request group, or our questions and answer group. And all these different channels are going to help us make our Sunday school a bit more interactive. Now, the first step to join is to ask your parents if you're allowed to join Discord. Now, guys, I really don't want you to go and beg your parents. Just ask them, and if they say no, don't worry, it's not the end of the world. They're only doing what is best for you. Now, the next step, if you are now allowed to join, is to download the Discord app on your phone. Now, guys, since you guys are still very young, I'm sure not all of you have your own phones or computers as yet, so you are allowed to join with your parents' phone or computer. Now, the next step is then to get the invite link from me over WhatsApp or Telegram. Now, guys, here comes the tricky part. I'm not just going to share the link with anybody. And the reason why is I don't want some creepy old dude on our server who just wants trouble. So the people who can join is only those who are actively part of Father's Heart Kidz. In other words, I need to know that you really are a child that is joining. Now, I know this might sound weird, but guys, it's for your safety. Now, to the parents, I really want to encourage you guys. If you are now allowing your kids to join Discord, whether it now be on your phone or maybe their own device, please go through their messages and make sure they are safe. We will now definitely keep an eye out on what's happening on the groups. But if a child now decides to personally message another child, it's kind of out of our hands. Which brings me to the next point. We are going to have some rules on the group that you guys need to follow so we can keep everyone safe. And I really want to encourage the parents to be part of this. You guys set the rules and the boundaries. If you decide your child is only allowed on Discord for maybe an hour between 6 and 7, for example, then that is 100% okay with us. So, with all of that said, guys, I look forward to seeing you guys on Discord and getting to know you guys a bit better. Now, before we go, let's quickly end off our lesson with prayer. Thank you, Jesus, for this amazing lesson we just had. Thank you for teaching us to love our enemies and setting the example for us. Lord, please help us to do the same and help us to always have faith, and please remind us to always turn to you when we need wisdom. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you do for us. Please guide us through this week and help us to apply this lesson each and every day. In Jesus' name we pray this and we all say Amen. So guys, I want you now to go and have an amazing week. See you guys next week Sunday. Bye, everyone!